I feel like I pour my heart and soul and sweat and tears. I haven't cried, but like if I cried, then yeah. This is a great question. Whoa, that's a lot of questions. But it's never been a moment where I'm like, oh, I don't want to go to work. I truly believe I would. Love your positivity of the love and the... Oh, I can't read. Sorry if I butcher your username. Welcome back to my channel. In today's video, I will be answering some of your questions. So depending on when you're watching this, either last week or longer than that, I posted a video as well as an Instagram picture asking you guys to ask me questions if you have ever been wanting to ask me something and I haven't gotten back to you. So this is a dedicated video to answering questions. I got over like 80 questions, so I don't think I'll be able to answer all of them in one sitting. So I'm gonna go ahead and answer 15 questions in this video, and I'm just gonna keep on going in 15 question like increment videos and just post them periodically until all the questions are answered. So let's go ahead and get started. So I screenshotted all the questions that were posted on the first day that the video was posted and the picture was posted. So that's how I'm going in order. All right, so first question comes from Instagram and it's from Jessica, and she asks, what do you think about teachers with a lot of tattoos? And personally, I'm not against tattoos. I don't have any myself, but I think as long as you can do your job efficiently and well, I don't think it should really matter. However, my opinion doesn't really matter. I think your employer's opinion matters. I know that some employers are very lenient when it comes to tattoos and other employers require you to cover them up, so it's just something that you need to consider when applying for a job and where you're applying. The next question comes from V. Leon, and she asks, do you ever see yourself going back to school for an endorsement in something? I'm currently getting my master's in bilingual education and an endorsement in special education. Love your positivity and love of the classroom. You're so pretty. Also, would you ever do makeup tutorials on your channel? All right, so for your first question, I feel like if I go back to school, I'm gonna get a master's, not necessarily an endorsement. Is there a difference? I'm not really sure. But I would definitely want to go get my master's. I'll talk a little bit more about that in later questions because that is actually a question that comes up a lot in this Q&A. So short answer, ideally, yes, I would love to go back to school. And then for your last question, where you ask if I would ever do makeup tutorials on my channel, I don't know if you know this, but I actually used to make makeup tutorials here on my channel. That is how my channel started. So a lot of people ask me like how I got so many subscribers. And that's because I've been making videos since like 2013, and I used to make makeup videos from 2013 up until early like 2017, I think. And that is how I was able to build a subscriber base. I think I had like 19,000 subscribers at the time before switching over to like more teaching related content. But to answer your question, I don't know if I would, just because I'm not like super into makeup like I once was before. Before, I used to be really into makeup. I always wanted to buy the newest launches of makeup, so whether it was high end or drugstore, but mostly drugstore, because I mean, broke college student can't buy super high end makeup all the time. Yeah, I like getting ready in the morning and doing my makeup, but I'm not super creative with it like I used to be, or I would try to be. If anything, I would post one makeup tutorial, and that would be my everyday makeup routine, because a lot of you asked me to do that, so that would probably come in the future. Next question comes also from Instagram, and she asks, if you could pick a career all over again, would you still choose to teach? And I truly believe I would. Sometimes I try to think of what I would be doing if I wasn't teaching, and I can't come up with a solid answer. There's really not a profession out there that I would rather do other than teach. Of course, maybe I would want to be famous and just be rich for nothing, but that is not very realistic. So teaching is just where my heart is, where my passion is, and it's just something that I feel like I'm good at. So I just love teaching and I wouldn't change it. Next question comes from Alyssa, and she asks, any advice for a college student doing observation or practicum hours in the classroom? Yes. So when I was doing my observation hours, I don't know about you, but I had to do a ton of observation hours every single semester. So what I started doing is I started keeping a journal every time I would go into the classroom. And to kind of organize my notes, I would write down certain things in different colors. So if I was writing down something that I liked or did not like about classroom management, I would maybe write it in like pink or something. If it was something math related, I would write it in blue, and so on and so forth. So if I ever had to look back at my notes, I could easily think like, oh wait, I'm looking for that one math activity that I saw, so I'm gonna look for something that's written in blue. So definitely take notes of whatever you're seeing, whether you like what you're seeing or you don't like what you're seeing, because you can learn either way. And also, even if you're just observing, try to get as hands-on as possible, because you learn more through hands-on experiences than you do through observation, in my opinion. And not only will you learn more, but you will also make a good impression on your mentor. tour teacher. All right, so next question comes from Princess underscore Kelsey, and she asks, any advice for someone who graduated with a certification last spring and is still applying everywhere? I know that getting a teacher job is very different from state to state. So I'm assuming you live in a state where there is not a teacher shortage. I live in Arizona, so there's a huge teacher shortage. So unfortunately, I don't really know what else to say, but just keep applying and don't give up. I would definitely recommend watching Pocketful Primary videos, especially the ones over the summer when she was looking for a job too in a state where there's not a teacher shortage and jobs are limited. So I'll try to link her video down below, but definitely go watch her video. She worked so hard to get the job that she wanted. She made sure that she personally dropped off her resumes and just applied online. I feel like that's definitely a big thing you can do because it puts a face to the name and it just makes a better first impression as well. Next question comes from Norris. Sorry if I butcher your username, but this person asks, do you plan on continuing your education, maybe leadership? Like I said, this question comes up a lot, and ideally I would want to continue my education. I love learning and I love implementing what I learn in the classroom. However, at the moment, I don't think it's something that is very feasible to me as a first year teacher. Now, I'm sure that if I put my mind to it, I would be able to accomplish it. However, I do have to think about a lot of factors, such as the cost of it and how busy I am right now. So, getting your master's degree is definitely not cheap in the slightest. Luckily, right now, I don't have a lot of student loan debt. I have a very, very small amount of student debt. That is very manageable for me with my salary, but if I went ahead and took out a $15,000 loan, then it would make things a lot more difficult for me financially. So as you know, teachers don't make a lot, and right now I am able to pay for everything myself, but I have very special circumstances that I'll talk about later with another question. So with paying my rent, my car, my bills and everything, I don't think adding a student loan bill on top of that is the best idea to do right now. Also, I am very busy. I am a first year teacher and I spend so much time in my classroom trying to get ready for the next day. And I just got engaged, so obviously I have to start planning a wedding, and planning a wedding, being a first year teacher, are just things that take up a lot of time, and school will just be another added stress that I don't think I would want to deal with if I can postpone that a little bit more. As far as leadership, at the moment, I don't think I would want to pursue leadership just because I love being in the classroom so much. And when you are in a leadership position, you're not really in the classroom as much and you're not as hands-on with kids learning as much either. So those two things are something that I would not want to give up to just pursue leadership, even though that would mean a pay increase. I don't think that's a trade-off I would want to participate in. All right, so the next question comes from EME I'm Body. This person asks, I'm a freshman in college and I'm an early childhood education major, and I was wondering what advice you have for a college student that wants to become a teacher. I get this question a lot, actually. I don't know why. And I guess it's because I was literally a college student last year. I think my biggest piece of advice is to get in the classroom as much as you can, even if that means outside of your practicum hours. So for me, I was very fortunate enough to have a job that allowed me to be in the classroom constantly. And I know that not everybody has this opportunity, but you can always just call schools, which is what I did when I was starting off in college, and just be like, hey, I'm a college student, I wanna pursue education, I wanna be able to get a little bit more experience in the classroom. Is there any way I can come and observe or maybe help out in some of your classrooms? And I'm pretty sure that someone will say yes, and they'll allow you to help or just observe in their classrooms, and that will give you so much experience and you will learn so much from that. Next question comes from Brenda, and she asks, have you ever had moments of not wanting to teach? If so, how did you overcome it? So far, I have not. I mean, I've had moments where I'm like waking up at 5 a.m, like, oh, like I don't want to get out of bed, but it's never been a moment where I'm like, oh, I don't want to go to work. I am always really excited to come to work. I'm always looking forward to come to work. And again, I just love it so much. And I think that saying is true. Like, if you love what you do, you'll never work a day in your life, because I do love what I do. And yeah, getting up in the morning is hard, but other than that, I wouldn't change it for the world. So no, I haven't had those days yet, fortunately. SIS for Curiosity asked, what is something that you are looking forward to doing different moving into your second year in kindergarten? What is something that worked well and that you want to keep doing? I'm excited to just have like a set of activities that I've done this year and just do them again next year and just like improve them. So for example, for our apple tasting event, I think it went well. After running it through one time, I already have some ideas of how to change it and make it run smoother. So I just kind of make notes on what I want to change. So does that make sense? I just want to do this all over again because I know that I'll be better next time around. I will definitely keep doing Class Dojo if I can. I will definitely still be doing student choice centers and just incorporate choice into the classroom as much as I can. Question number 10 comes from Milana Manfredo 23. Probably not saying. Ask, what was the hardest interview question you had to answer? I honestly cannot remember my interview questions very much. So I don't think the actual interview itself, like face-to-face interview, was hard. However, I do remember an application question that I had to answer. My application process was your typical application process where you answer like, how old you are, when did you graduate, references, and stuff like that. But it also had essay questions. I had about 5 essay questions, and I remember having one that was a little bit difficult for me to answer because I didn't really know what to say. I don't remember exactly what the question was, but it was something along the lines like, your colleague is like being very negative and down on themselves and is blaming their shortcomings onto the students. How do you deal with that? So that was definitely my hardest like interview question. Next question comes from Eileen, and she asks, what is something you wish you would have learned / studied / practiced more of in your school before getting into your own classroom? I don't really know, because I feel like school cannot truly prepare you for being a teacher in your own classroom. A lot of things that go into teaching come through experience and not so much through studying, in my opinion. I mean, you might have a different opinion, but that's just what I think. But if anything, in college, I wish we would have covered more about communication, whether that is communication with your parents, communication with your students, communication with your administration, or communication with your coworkers. I feel like that's a very important skill that is often overlooked in teacher preparation programs. So, yeah, just communication. Next question comes from Selena on Instagram, and she asks, what is something you wish you had learned while student teaching to help you feel more prepared in the classroom? I wish I would have learned a little bit more organizational strategies, or like different organizational strategies, so I can find one that works for me. Right now, I've been trying so many, and it's just more like a trial and error, so I wish I could save that time and just have a repertoire of options, which I don't have, but yeah. Next question comes from xxcarmen3. And she asks, I'm currently going to college for childhood education. How did you stay motivated through college? I think I stayed motivated because I knew that at the end of this journey, I would have my own classroom, and that was something that I was looking forward to very, very much. So just like knowing that there's a light at the end of the tunnel kept me motivated, because I really, really, really wanted to have my own classroom. Next question comes from Emma Young, 2312, and she asks, what was the most unexpected challenge you faced in your first year of teaching? My most unexpected challenge so far has definitely been trying to balance my personal life with my professional life. Like I said, I spend a ton of time in my classroom, so when I have a family emergency, which I've had plenty of so far, unfortunately, it's just kind of hard to deal with it, and I don't really know how to deal with it, so that has definitely been my biggest challenge. All right, so last question for this video, because my camera's gonna die, comes from Jessie Loves Jay, and she asks, you think your pay is extremely low for all that you do? This is a great question. Everybody knows that teachers are not paid well. Teachers make very little money, and it really changes from state to state. Arizona is one of the lowest paying states in the US, and I live in Arizona. Now, going into teaching, I knew this, and I knew exactly how much I was gonna get paid when I signed my contract. However, I was still kind of shocked at how little teachers get paid. And I honestly don't know how teachers that have kids make it by themselves. Right now, I live by myself, and I don't provide for anyone else but myself, so I am able to get by all right. I don't have a ton of money left over, and that is partly because I'm not great at managing my own money. Again, this is something that I knew initially, and I knew going into it, but it's still kind of hard to deal with, and sometimes it is a little bit discouraging because I feel like I pour my heart and soul and sweat and tears. I haven't cried, but like if I cried, then yeah, into this profession to do the best job that I can possibly do, and yet I'm compensated very poorly. And it's not the school's fault, it's not the district's fault. It is just a very broken system that the US has. And so short answer is, yeah, I think my pay is low for what I do, but I don't think I'd change it. And it's just me right now. To be completely honest with you, if I had like a kid that depended on me, I don't know if I would be able to just do teaching and be okay. I definitely have to have another job, which I currently do actually have another job. I work over breaks, like spring break, winter break, and all that. I work a second job just to kind of have the security blanket, but yeah, I would definitely have to work another job if I had dependents. Luckily, I don't, and luckily I'll get married soon. Alright, so that is it for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it, and if you did, please give this video a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, and I'll be answering more of your questions in future videos. So go ahead and subscribe, hit that notification button so you don't miss those videos. And thank you so much for sending me your questions. I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!